Have you ever been inspired by a stunning photograph of a wild animal or a natural landscape? Hey, I'm David Mizajewski with the National Wildlife Federation. Each year, we hold a photo contest, and this year, we want you to submit your photos. And you don't need to be an expert photographer either. In fact, while we have a professional division, we get the most submissions in our amateur division from regular folks just like you. By participating, you can help us inspire people to care about wildlife with your photographs. And you can win a prize at the same time. With me now is John Noon. John's photo director for National Wildlife Magazine. So John, tell us what you're looking for in a winning photograph.
Oh, thanks, Dave. There are five factors our judges consider when reviewing entries. These are originality, technical excellence, composition, artistic merit, and overall impact. All these factors are included in our rules.
Right, and you actually have some examples of each one of those, right?
I sure do. The first one, originality. Now, I've seen a lot of cedar waxwing images, but this second place winning photo was very original. The photographer's companion was looking in a field guide at differences between a cedar waxwing and a bohemian waxwing when the bird got curious. You never know when a photo opportunity may arise, so have your camera ready.
I totally love that picture. I think it's just great. So what's the next criteria?
Well, the next one, Dave, is technical excellence. Now, remember when we were told that we shouldn't photograph against the sun? But this first place winner of a mother and child dancing on the beach shows you can do this quite effectively if you select the right camera settings. That means the right exposure, shutter speed, white balance, and depth of field.
Yeah, I mean, that is another amazing photo. And I mean, you can tell that this person did the right things because otherwise it would just be bleached out.
Correct.
All right, so what's the next one?
The next one is composition. Now, this entry was a finalist. It has great balance, and the placement and strong color of the canoe emphasizes the whiteness of the scene. Now, cropping a photo can often help composition. Try different croppings until you find one you like, and don't be afraid to enlarge just a portion of the frame.
Right, and so it's pretty fair to say that composition is the way the things in the photo relate to each other.
Absolutely.
Okay, so what's the next one?
The fourth one is artistic merit. All the elements came together right for this photographer. The large elk, the double rainbow, the sun highlighting the bands of rain. The photographer didn't let weather stop her from shooting, and she was rewarded with this beautiful wildlife landscape. Sunny blue skies have their place, but what we might consider bad weather can add a lot of drama to a photograph.
That's right, so you can't be afraid of a little rain, right?
Oh no, get out there.
All right, so what's the last one?
The last one is the photo's overall impact. This first place winning image of an indigo bunting is sharp, well lit, and the bird contrasts well against the palm leaf background. The wing spread also adds implied motion. This was the cover of a recent issue of National Wildlife. You can read how the photographer made the photo on our website.
Yeah, and I have to say, this is truly an inspirational photo. So thanks, John, for sharing your wisdom with us. Don't be afraid to submit your photos. It really is a lot easier than you think. So joining me now is Hannah Sharp. She's the editor of National Wildlife Magazine's Photo Zone website. And Hannah, you've got some really good advice for amateurs on how they can take some great pictures.
Well, thanks, Dave. I want to help people get over the intimidation factor and feel like they can get out there and just take pictures no matter what. So first of all, I want people to know that no matter what sort of equipment they have, what sort of camera, they can take a winning photograph. For example, one of our winners from last year took her first place winning photo with a $100 point and shoot camera on autofocus.
Wow, that's amazing. So this photo right here is one of the winners.
That's right.
That is just totally awesome. All right, so what's some more advice?
Well, I know for people who have kids and jobs, which is most of us, it's hard to get outside and make the time to actually take photos that you would want to enter in a contest. But if you make it just part of your life and you get out there with your kids, bring your camera along and go ahead and take pictures no matter what.
Yeah, sometimes it's just a matter of actually having the camera in your pocket and you never know what you're going to run across.
Exactly.
Right. Okay. So any more advice?
Sure. Well, you know, this is a wildlife photography contest, so people think, if I don't have a photo of a tiger or a buffalo, maybe I don't have anything to submit. But the truth is, we have wildlife all around us. In my backyard, there are butterflies. In my front yard, there are earthworms. Not that, you know, an earthworm has ever won, but that remains to be seen.
You never know, right?
Yeah.
And it really is true that there's nature all around us. It's literally right outside our door.
Exactly.
So great advice. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
There you have it. It's a lot easier than you think to take a great photo of wildlife or nature. To get even more tips on taking great pictures, to read the contest rules and learn about the prizes, and of course to submit your photos, just go to nwf.org/phototips. We can't wait to see your entries in the National Wildlife Photo Contest.